Do you have an RDI filter that's supposed to produce 75 gallons per day but just doesn't? Or maybe you burn through DI resin faster than I can go through a bag of Famous Amos cookies? If so, installing an RODI booster pump with an auto flush valve may solve your problem. Matthew here, your BRS beginner guru. Let's upgrade your RODI filter. For this project, you're going to need the booster pump, transformer, and the auto flush flow restrictor. If you want the pump to automatically turn off once your RODI reservoir is full, you will also need a pressure switch. It can be a little confusing trying to figure out exactly what to buy, so start out by purchasing the auto flush flow kit. If you have a 75 gallon per day or a 150 gallon per day RODI system, get the 75 gallon system. But if your filter is 100 gallons per day or 200 gallons per day, then go with the 100 gallon per day auto flush flow kit. The kit comes with everything you're going to need except for the booster pump itself, so add that to the cart as well. RODI filters function at their absolute best with a minimum pressure of 50 psi all the way up to 75 or even 80 psi. The booster pump will not only increase the water pressure entering your RODI system, it also has these three benefits. Firstly, your RODI filter will produce less wastewater. Secondly, your RO membrane will reject more dissolved solids. And thirdly, your DI resin will be depleted at a much slower rate. The auto flush flow restrictor will automatically flush your RO membrane every time it starts up and then periodically during filtering. This helps reduce or eliminate the dreaded TDS creep, whereby a ton of dissolved solids will enter into your RODI reservoir every time you start your RODI filter. The pressure switch, when combined with a float valve, detects when your RODI reservoir is full and will automatically turn off the booster pump. Although it looks a bit daunting, installation is actually really easy. Step one, decide where to put the booster pump. You can just set it on a solid surface or mount it to the inside of a cabinet or to the wall. Step two, install the booster pump. The booster pump goes between the water source, for most of us that's the faucet, and the RODI unit itself. Simply cut the red RO tubing at any point between the faucet and the RODI filter and insert the booster into place. Follow the arrows on the top of the booster pump for the correct flow direction. Step three, replace the manual flush valve with the auto flush flow restrictor. The manual flush valve is located on the black, dirty water line immediately after the RO membrane. Simply remove the manual flush valve by pressing the grommet into the pressure fitting while pulling the RO tubing in the opposite direction. Then install the new auto flush flow restrictor in the proper direction by following the in and arrow indicators. Step four, install the pressure switch. The easiest step yet, you'll only want to install the pressure switch if you already have a float valve in place, which will automatically detect when your RODI reservoir is full. Just cut the blue product water line in between the RODI filter and the clean water container. Then insert the two ends into the pressure switch. There is no proper direction here, so you can install it any way you see fit. And finally, step five, connect all the wires. This is by far the most confusing part. If you're installing both the auto flush flow restrictor and the pressure switch, here's how you do it. Starting with the booster pump, connect one end of the splitter to the pump. Connect the other single end to the auto flush flow restrictor. Then connect the second end of the splitter to the pressure switch. Finally, connect the pressure switch to the transformer. If you don't need the pressure switch, then installation is even easier. Simply connect the booster pump to the double-sided end of the splitter. Then connect the single side of the splitter to the auto flush flow restrictor. Lastly, connect the remaining side to the transformer and you're done. If you struggle to understand the intricacies of RODI systems, you're not alone because I still do as well. Luckily, we can both watch this video right here to both increase the total water output and reduce the amount of DI resin we burn through. And as always, everyone, thanks for watching. Happy reefing, be well. We'll see you next time.